Yes, my name is Adedoyin Jeremiah, popularly known as Presto Math or Jerry Springer. So we are going to continue our lecture on Lebesgue Measure and Integration, and I would like you to subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more of mathematics tutorial and they are well explanatory. Thank you. We are going to continue from where we stopped. We have treated some theorems on Lebesgue measure. We started from the outer measure and now we are on Lebesgue measure. So we are going to start with a proposition today. Some proposition we need to prove on Lebesgue measure and integration. The first is to, if En or let En be an increasing sequence, of measurable sets. Then the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of En will be equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the outer measure of En. So then number 2 is if En or let rather En be a decreasing sequence of measurable sets such that measure of E1 is finite, that it is less than infinity, then the measure of the intersection, of En is also equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. So this is the proof we are going to start with today. So proof. For the first one, I have let En be an increasing sequence of measurable sets. Then the measure of the union of En from n starting from 1 to infinity is equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. And number 2 as well, let En be a decreasing sequence of measurable sets such that the measure of E1 is finite, that is less than infinity. Then the measure of the intersection of n of En, of the total intersection of the sequence, will be equal to the limit of as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. So for the first one, now we have this, of course we can see that it's an increasing sequence of measurable sets. Now the first thing we need to do here is that, number one is, if there exists n naught such that, the measure of En naught is equal to infinity. So, there are two cases actually. If one of the sets here, you know, they say let En be an increasing sequence of measurable sets. If one of them, the measure is infinity, then what will happen? If one of them, the measure is infinity, what happens is that, since we have measure of En naught to be equal to infinity, then since En naught is fully contained in the union. Since yes, N naught. N naught means one of them. This N naught means one of this, one of what is here. So if one of them is the measure of one of them is equal to infinity. So since I have one of them is obviously inside the union. It's inside the union of everything. So what happened is that by monotonicity, the measure of En, En naught, will be less or equal to the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of En. And that means that the measure of the union, that means the measure of the union from n starting from 1 to infinity of En will be greater than or equal to the measure of En naught. And since this is En naught and I say it's equal to infinity, it means that the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of En is also equal to infinity. So since that, so that means the left hand side here is equal to infinity. And again, for all n in n, such that n is greater than n naught, for all n in n, such that n is greater than n naught, what will happen? En naught will be inside En. Why? Because En is an increasing sequence of measurable set. So since it's an increasing sequence of measurable sets, that means since n is greater than n naught, that means En will be greater than will be a superset of En naught. Or we say En naught is inside En. So that's what we are going to have here. See, if En naught is inside En, it means that by monotonicity again, the outer measure of or the measure of En naught will be less than the measure of En. And since the measure of En naught is infinity, so that means that the measure of En will also be infinity. So it follows that the measure of En, will also be equal to infinity. So and that means that the limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En will also be equal to infinity. So that means they are equal. Therefore, the measure of n starting from 1 to infinity of the union of the En is equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. So that's what we are going to have. Now, that is for the first case. Suppose there is this one such that it is of the measure is not finite, that this is infinity. But now let us now do the main proof. Now suppose for all n in n, En is less than infinity, that is, suppose for all n in n, En is less than infinity. So what are we going to have? Since En is less than infinity, what are we going to have? What we are going to have is that the measure of En is less than infinity. That is, for every of the increasing sequence, suppose all of them are of finite measure, what happened? What will happen is that we'll have to define, since they did not tell us that they are disjoint, although we can suppose without loss of generality that they are disjoint. But since we are not told that they are disjoint, we have to create another set so that so that they will be disjoint and their union will be the same. So we say let F1 be equal to E1. Let F1 or define F1 to be equal to E1 and Fn to be equal to En minus 1. I think I don't need this one. I don't need this. So minus 1 for all n in n. So and let E naught be equal to the empty set. So that means F1 will be equal to E1. So that's what we are going to have. So Fn, let us define it to be equal to En minus 1 for all n in n, and let E naught be equal to the empty set. That's what we are going to do now. So let Fn be equal to En minus En minus 1 for all n in n, and let E naught be equal to the empty set. Since it's an increasing sequence, it's increasing. That means E1, E2 is greater than E1, E3 is greater than E2, E4 is greater than E3, and on like that. What I have defined here, this all the Fn's will be disjoint, because I'm subtracting the bigger set from the smaller one, and there will not be any intersection. So now notice that the Fn's are disjoint. Notice that the Fn's are disjoint measurable set. The Fn's are disjoint measurable set. And what happened is that the union from n starting from 1 to infinity of Fn is actually equal to the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the En's. Because by the time you put F1, F2, F3, F4 all together, you will see that they are the same. Suppose this is F1, of course, F1 is equal to E1. F2 will be E2 minus E1. So, but if you do F1 union F2, for instance, I just want to show you that they are the same, that this is true. And suppose I have F1 union F2. F1 union F2 will actually be E1 union E2 minus E1. This one will contain, this one will eventually become E1 union E2. So the union of Fn's, or the union of Fn is equal to the union of the En's. That is what I'm trying to say. So at the end of the day, so that means that, so since we know this, this is important. The Fn's are disjoint measurable sets, and the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the Fn's is equal to the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the En's. So that means that now we record that Fn's is equal to the Fn is equal to En minus En minus 1. So that means the measure of union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the Fn will be equal to the measure of union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the Fn. The Fn is equal to En minus En minus 1. So I have En minus En minus 1. So that's what I'm going to have. That's what I'm going to have there. So the next thing I'm going to do now is that, so the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of Fn is equal to the, so of course I've told you the union will come out. When the union comes out, it becomes summation. Since they are disjoint, that's why equality holds. Assuming it's not disjoint, it will be less or equal. So it's equal to n starting from 1 to infinity of the measure of En minus En minus 1. So that is what I'm going to have. So when I have this, so since they are all finite, they are finite measure, I can separate it. The theorem I'm using will still be proved later on in this lecture. The theorem I'm using, the escission property. It's called the escission property. I'm still going to prove it in later in this lecture. So, but this one will become summation of n starting from 1 to infinity of, this one will now become the measure of En minus measure of En minus 1. So this is a measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of all the Fn's, of the union of the Fn. So that's what I'm going to have. So I'm going to be putting the values, I'm going to be, by the time we do this summation, or I have a measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the of fn to be equal to, since I have to infinity, I write limit as n goes to infinity of summation of I use k now, k starting from 1 to n, k starting from 1 to n of measure of ek minus measure of ek minus 1, ek minus 1. That is what I'm going to have. So this one, since it is summation of n starting from 1 to infinity, I can change this n to k, so that I have k starting from 1 to infinity. So this is what I'm going to have. So I can have this, it's just a change of notation. So since it's to infinity, I can write limit as n goes to infinity. Instead of writing infinity, I write n as n goes to infinity, k starting from 1 to n of this. So now, this is telescoping. That is, let me just show you what I'm trying to say. When k is 1, I will have the measure of E1 minus measure of E0 plus, when k is 2, I will have measure of E2 minus measure of E1. So now, look at this first two I am adding. You will see that measure of E1 cancel measure of E1. You will see, even if I add the third one, let me add the third one for instance. When k is 3, I will have measure of E3 minus measure of E2. So, if I add the third one, I will have plus measure of E3 minus measure of E2. You will see that the measure of E3 will cancel the measure of E2. So, I will be left with measure of E3 minus measure of E0. So, since it is still n, by the time I evaluate this summation, this one will become, after evaluating the summation, I have outer measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of fn to be equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of. Now, this one, what I'm going to have at the end of the day is that this one will be measure of en minus measure of E naught. That's what I'm going to obtain at the end of the day. I will have measure of En minus measure of E naught by the time I evaluate this summation. You can compute it yourself, put k to be 1 till n, you will see that they are telescoping, that is, they cancel each other. Each of the times cancel each other until you come to, you get to this place. So at the end of the day, you have measure of En minus measure of E naught. But the measure of E naught is the empty set. So I have measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of fn to be equal to limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of en minus outer measure of the empty set. So the outer measure of the empty set is 0, or the measure of the empty set, the measure of an empty set is 0. The proof will be supplied later after I prove this excision property. So this is 0, so that at the end of the day I have measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of fn to be equal to limit as n goes to infinity of measure of en. So this is 0. That one is 0. Measure of the empty set is 0. So replace this fn with en. The measure of fn is equal to the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the fn is equal to the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of the en. So that at the end of the day, let me manage this list, and we have the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of en is equal to limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of en. So I'm done with the first proof. The first proof says that let En be an increasing sequence of measurable sets, then the measure of the union of n starting from 1 to infinity of En is equal to limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. And that is what I obtained here. That's what I have here. So I've proved the first one. Now let's go to the second proof. So to do the second one, I have let En be a decreasing sequence of measurable sets such that the outer the measure of E1 is less than infinity, that is, the measure is finite, then the measure of their intersection will be equal to the limit, will be equal to limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. We want to do the second proof now. So for the second one, we know that the measure, all of them are, since they are decreasing, and that means E1 is greater than E2, is greater than E3, is bigger than E4, like that. So, and since E1 is a finite measure, that means all of them too are finite measure. So I don't need to consider any case of, when one of them is infinity, since they are decreasing, and that means that means E1 is the largest, and since the measure of E1 is even finite, that it is less than infinity, that means all of them are a finite measure. So I will say let E be equal to their intersection. So let E be equal to their intersection. Intersection of everything. So what I'm going to do now is that E1 is the largest. So I'll do E1 minus E. If I do E1 minus E, I'm not going to prove, but what I'm going to have here is that I'm going to obtain E1 minus E2 union E2 minus E3 union and on like that. So that means I'm going to have E1 minus E will be equal to union of K starting from 1 to infinity. K starting from 1 to infinity of EK minus EK minus 1. That's what I'm going to obtain. And all these are disjoint. So notice that the EK minus EK minus 1 are disjoint, are disjoint measurable sets. So again, I will still prove to you that the union of two measurable sets is measurable. If two sets are measurable, their union is measurable, their intersection is measurable. I've proved that the complement of a measurable set is also measurable. So now notice that the EK minus EK minus 1 are disjoint measurable sets. So that's what I have. So the next thing I'm going to do now is that since they are disjoint measurable sets, if I take the measure, that is, take the measure of both sides, that means the measure of E1 minus E will be equal to the measure of union of K starting from 1 to infinity of EK minus EK minus 1. That's what I'm going to have. So I have measure of E1 minus E to be equal to, the union will come out, it becomes summation of K starting from 1 to infinity of the measure of EK minus EK minus 1. That's what I'm going to have. So again, by the excision property, I have the measure of E1 minus measure of E to be equal to summation of K starting from 1 to infinity of the measure of EK minus measure of EK minus 1. That is what I'm going to have. So that at the end of the day, what this is what I'm going to obtain. So that at the end of the day, I'm going to have going to have measure of E1 minus measure of E. Again, this one will become limit. This one will become limit as n goes to infinity of summation of k starting from 1 to n of the measure of ek minus measure of ek minus 1. Minus measure of ek minus 1. So that is what I'm going to have like this. So now, again, this is also a telescoping series. By the time we evaluate or take the sum of the series, we are going to they will cancel out. So this one will become E1 minus E0. This one will become E1 minus E0. So I have measure of E1 minus measure of E to be equal to limit as n goes to infinity of summation of k starting from 1 to n of the measure of ek minus measure of ek minus 1. So from here it's supposed to be plus 1. It's since it's e1 minus e2, e2 minus e3, this is plus 1. This is plus 1. So this is to be plus 1. So now this one will be E1 minus E2 plus E2 minus E3 plus E3 minus E4 plus E4 minus E5. You see that we are actually going to obtain a telescoping sum. They will all cancel out and we are going to be left with limit as n goes to infinity. At the end of the day here, the summation of k starting from 1 to n of this will become measure of E1 minus measure of En. That is what we are going to obtain. Measure of E1 minus the measure of En. So you can see that our measure of E1 minus measure of E to be equal to, since there is no, there is, this one will become measure of E1 minus limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En, of the measure of En. So that at the end of the day, I'm going to be E1, measure of E1 will cancel measure of E1, and bring this here, take this to the other, by removing the sign, of course, by rearranging, you will be left with measure of E is equal to limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. And what is E? Put E back. E is the intersection. So that means that at the end of the hour, measure of the intersection of n in n of En to be equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of the measure of En. So that is what I'm going to have as the answer. So I will have, so that's and that's the proof of the second one. So I have the measure of the intersection of n in n of En to be equal to limit as n goes to infinity of measure of En. So that is for the first two proofs.